Good morning, children. Welcome back after a long summer break. I hope you must have enjoyed a lot in this period the way you can. And now you are again ready, energetic, enthusiastic to start with the syllabus of July. The first chapter which I am going to start today is physical and chemical change. Based on the previous knowledge in class 6, you must have done reversible and irreversible change, slow and fast change, natural change, and some other types of changes. Here, in this chapter, we are going to study about physical and chemical changes. Some changes are fast, some are slow, some can be reversed, some cannot be reversed. When we get up early in the morning, our day starts with rising of the sun. When we sleep at night, it was entire darkness, and when we get up in the morning, it was complete fresh day. How it happens that all of a sudden the sun appears in the sky? This is all the changes. Some are natural, some are man-made, some are important, some are desirable, some are not desirable. Some can be reversed back, some cannot be reversed back. So broadly, we can classify them into so many changes. But here, in this chapter number 6, we are going to start about physical and chemical change. First, children, I am going to tell you about what is physical change. A physical change is a change in which no new substance is formed. In a physical change, the substances involved do not change their identity, means they remain the same. I'll tell you this by giving an example. Suppose you take a paper and tear the paper into two halves. The paper remains the paper, only the shape is changed, size is changed, but the properties of paper remain the same. They can be easily returned to the original position, original form by some physical process. These means that physical changes can be reversed. Not all, most of the physical changes are reversible, like freezing of water, water changing into ice, ice again to water, boiling of water, water changes to water vapor, and water vapor again comes back to water. So some and most of the physical changes are reversible. The changes in physical state, size, and shape of the substance are physical changes. Some common example of physical changes are melting of ice, freezing of water, boiling of water, condensation of steam, making a solution, glowing of electric bulb, breaking of glass tumbler, crystallization. These are some of the common examples of physical change. Now come to the chemical change. The changes in which new substances are formed with entirely different properties is called a chemical change. In a chemical change, the substance involved change their identity. They got converted into entirely different substance with entirely new properties. The new substances usually cannot be returned to their original form. This means that chemical changes are usually irreversible. Not all, I say usually, most of them. Some common examples are burning of paper, burning of magnesium wire, rusting of iron, formation of curd from milk, cooking of food, digestion of food. The best example of chemical change is rusting of iron. Very important concept in this chapter. I am going to start. Number one, what is rust? Rust is a brown color deposit appeared on the surface of the iron metal due to action of oxygen and moisture. It's called the rust. Iron objects such as nails, bolts, etc., if exposed to oxygen and water, develop a reddish brown deposit on the surface after a few days. This layer of deposit on them is called the rust, and the process is known as a sect. The chemical reaction that takes place is due to the reaction of iron with oxygen, I told you here, moisture, that is water. This reaction produces iron oxide, and actually the iron oxide is rust only. The equation you have to understand and keep in your mind: iron Fe plus oxygen from the air plus water H2O form the rust iron oxide, and the chemical name is Fe2O3. Now you all understood what is rust, what is rusting, chemical equation and the condition required. Last but not the least, I tell you how can you prevent rusting. Rusting can be prevented either by the oiling or by the painting the iron objects. The surface of iron objects or by galvanization. So what is galvanization? It is a process of coating of iron objects with zinc. This is called galvanization. You all must have seen that pipes carrying water in cities are galvanized to prevent them from rusting. What is crystallization? The method of separation of pure crystals of a substance from its hot and supersaturated solution on cooling is called crystallization. You all must have read in class 6 that how can we make salt from the seawater? Yes, we have explained you. In crystals, the molecule of the substance get arranged to form a regular pattern, and the process of crystallization is used for obtaining the pure crystal from its impure sample. I told you the common salt is obtained from the seawater by this evaporation and crystallization. First, the water is collected in the shallow beds or the lagoons. Water evaporates slowly, slowly, leaving behind the crystals of common salt. And this common salt is then purified by crystallization infections. Last topic I'm going to tell you is our protective shield. You must have learned or heard the name of ozone layer. Where is ozone layer present? Ozone layer is a layer in the atmosphere, in the upper surface, which protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. The main, you can say, the function of ozone layer is it absorbs the harmful radiation and breaks down to oxygen. Oxygen is different from the ozone. Please make it clear in your minds. Breaking down of ozone into oxygen is a perfect chemical change. If ultraviolet radiation were not absorbed by the ozone, it would reach the Earth's surface and cause harm to us and other life forms. Ozone acts as a natural shield against this radiation. So ozone layer can be depleted by the too much of pollution nowadays in the atmosphere, and if there is a hole in the ozone layer, the life will not be possible for animals, human beings as well as the plants. So it is very important that we have to protect this protective shield. I think the chapter is clear to you all. Thank you very much.